Morning YouTube, here we are again with another video, and someone has asked, based on the previous videos, what is this Scientology malarkey and why is everybody so upset about it? Well, in a simple video like this I can only give you a basic overview, so there's going to be loads of links in the hoo-ha bar, as normal. But the long story short is it started with this. It's a book called Dianetics, by a guy by the name of L. Ron Hubbard, who's no longer around. Now, the basic science of this is to stop the reactive mind. Like, for example, if I saw a spider, I go, before I've had a chance to think about things and be in control of my own reactions. And the overall goal is to work up to being clear, clear of reactive mind. I know I'm putting this forward simply, but it's the best I can do in a video. There is a link overall. First link in the hoo-ha bar is going to be to Scientology Beliefs and Practices. In this book, it claims to be the science of the mind. But in my readings, I haven't found anything in the way of serious science. And the only thing nodded towards religion that I can find in here is actually the belief in reincarnation. That's it. No deities. And a lot of this stuff is opinion, as I said. More on the clear is link number two. But I actually put a blog together. I went through this methodically. I think only after reading it, I decided I'm going to go through this piece by piece and try and unpick it, because it is a bit difficult. And I think I said about it... the chapter is full of statements of things that are scientific fact, but there is no proof or reference to support these statements. Without such proof, these facts are unproven and can only be held in doubt pending such proof. This is not theory, this is scientific fact. It's strictly test tube. Then show us the tube. That's basically what I'm saying throughout this. The mechanisms of auditing are basically people going through the past experiences which are causing them trouble, and in revisiting them and becoming more familiar with them, they eventually overcome them. That is the basics of it. In Dianetics itself, L. Ron states something along the lines of that they can't actually make Dianetics illegal, because the only way to do that is to outlaw one man telling another of his troubles. That's not a direct quote, but it's the core of what is in there. Unlike religions, in the UK, Scientology has been officially branded a cult by a court judge. It's not regarded as a religion in the UK. You know, most religions, you can walk in through the front door, and pending you being something which is against those religions, for example, being a transsexual, there's no way that the official bodies of Islam would take me. Although there are transsexuals who follow Islam. They just don't get official blessing from any of the organized bodies. But that doesn't stop them. So pending anything like that, you can walk into a religion and the religion is normally open about its beliefs, about its teachings. Typically they'll give you a copy of their scripture and invite you to their services and to become part of their community. With Scientology, it's different. Those texts will cost you. Auditing will cost you. There's a link in there, how much does Scientology cost? I think that's actually going to be one of the last links, if not the last link. And it's estimated that the cost of reaching the clear state in Scientology is $128,000. That's an awful lot of money. Again, on my blog about this Dianetic Journey, I state, firstly, a clear is not a maintainable state of being. The clear is not immune from further aberrations. Also, the fact of being clear can only be ascertained using current knowledge, which may actually be false. It is also only possible to audit known engrams, and if engrams still exist which are not audited out, then the belief in being clear is simply that, a belief, and not a known fact. It is, and can never be any more than, a state of belief rather than an actual factual state of being. So that's an awful lot of money basically being spent on achieving something which doesn't seem to be a full goal, if you know what I mean. And there's an awful lot of stuff running around about the cult. The official cult, that is. the one that has its UK base in St Hill in East Grinstead, just up the road. Some of those accusations that are levelled are imprisonment, child slavery, and all sorts. One of the links is going to be A Childhood in Scientology, Tanya Neujahr. I can't pronounce her surname. It's a series of videos on YouTube in which she describes her time as a child in St Hill. One of the things that she reports is that when the link between the toilets and the septic tank broke down, and she was among a number who were physically moving with their bare hands human feces from the toilet to the cesspit. That is something that she claims in her videos. So it's worth watching that to get just a look at some of the allegations that are going around. There's more. Operation Clambake has been a long-running voice against Scientology, and now comprises of a number of people who have been high up in the cult and have left it, blown, as it's known, and some have even gone on to write books, and some of which I've got downstairs. Ironically enough, a lot of the voices against the cult have actually come as a result of the cult's own actions. If the cult hadn't done what some of the stuff that it had done, then it wouldn't have risen to notoriety. You'll notice a V for Vendetta mask behind me on occasions. It's about there. There. And that has been... The long story short is there was a video put out by Tom Cruise. It went viral, it got made public, and the cult tried to silence it. In trying to silence it, it then enraged Anonymous, who then stood up for internet freedom and censorship against the cult's censorship of that video. And it sparked off an whole series of protests and all sorts of stuff. And the same thing is happening today. Whether the cult has learnt from those lessons, I don't know. Everything has gone quite silent from the public side of things, apart from the recent stuff with John Sweeney raising his head above the parapet yet again. Good on him. So the majority of what is upsetting here is what the cult is doing. What the cult has done, its behaviour towards people, various things which have been brought out and confirmed as happening by the people who have left the cult, and obviously the cult is turning around and saying on its behalf that that these people have left with a grudge and they've got an axe to grind. You know, this kind of thing is working its way out, but this still does leave the underlying tech as it's known, the techniques that are used. And there is something, another couple of links in there. One is going to be to Geir Isene. I've probably mispronounced his name as well, my apologies. And he put me onto this L. Ron Hubbard book, Self-Analysis. Now, I've got to admit that I haven't read this. And I haven't read it because of the analysis that I did of Dianetics itself. But there is what's called the free church, which allows you access to the materials and a few other things for the study, etc., etc. Destination total freedom? I don't think so. Destination bankrupt, I think. There are what are called free zones, free churches. There's going to be a link to a Wikipedia on the free zone, and at the bottom you will find links in there to the various organizations which are practicing the tech but are outside the cult. The cult, I believe, reports say that the cult itself has tried to shut down these free groups because they are not charging for the materials. But the ultimate question is as to whether the tech actually works. Like I said in the previous bit about the clear, I have my doubts. I don't believe that it's possible to maintain an actual state of clear. But that's not to say that doing things, various things on the route, might actually deliver benefits. However, some of the things in, if you are going to go to the root of the very start of this, there are a few things that you need to be aware of, and that is that things have moved on, science has moved on, Dianetics doesn't seem to have, still seems to be rooted in an anchor, but science has moved on. One of the things that the cult holds is an extreme hatred of psychiatry. And if psychiatry has to hold its hands up, things like lobotomies, frontal lobotomies, you know, we look at them now and think how horrific they are. But believe it or not, if you actually do the research into frontal lobotomies, there are a few people that it actually helped, believe it or not. But on the whole, they are now avoided. Science has moved on. Psychiatry has moved on. And also other things have moved on as well. There's one thing which is in this book, and it concerns someone with a child with asthma. Blah, 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 blah. One is reminded of a case which has severe asthma. He had received it in a very severe birth engram. His frantic parents carried him to every mountain asthma resort suggested and spent tens of thousands of dollars in these jauntings. When this patient was cleared and the engram refiled, it was discovered that the restimulator for his asthma was clean, cold air. The only certainty in the environment approach is that a sickly child will recover when removed from restimulative parents and taken where he is loved and feels safe, for his sickness is the inevitable result of restimulation of prenatal engrams by one or the other of or both his parents. And basically what they're saying is that it's the actual child being in the presence of the parents which is triggering an engram, which is causing which the child received prenatally. And the only solution to this is to remove the child from one or other parents that are causing the re-stimulation. but like I say, things have moved on. I write, let's examine this. Asthma is when breathing is made more difficult due to a narrowing of the airwaves that lead to the lungs. This is due to a swelling or inflammation and has various triggers. Amazingly, one of those triggers includes cold air. Yahoo Health, and I quote Yahoo Health, asthma affects people in different ways. Some people only have asthma attacks during allergy season, or when they breathe in cold air, or when they exercise. Others may have many bad attacks that send them to the doctor often. From the National Institute of Health, which I link, common asthma triggers include animals, pet hair or dander, dust, changes in weather, most often cold weather, chemicals in the air or in food, exercise, mold, pollen, respiratory infections such as the common cold, strong emotions, stress, tobacco smoke. So science has moved on, and a lot of the things that I analysed in Dianetics, you know, they now have more scientifically and trustable solutions other than the kind of solutions like being in the presence of a parent that caused a prenatal engram. So the core of the original book, you know, I can only sum up as not having any scientific base. It's a lot of opinion with nothing actual to back it up. It says that such and such is scientific fact, but if you try and find the scientific fact, you can't find it, or I haven't been able to. And beyond a belief in reincarnation, there's nothing in terms of deity in there, nothing to support religion per se. So I've got a real problem with Dianetics itself. And this was actually the new edition. When was this edition put out? I think it was in the 1950s. There should be a date in here somewhere. The telephone number for Sotten is really old. Oh no, it's re-stamped with... Oh, this book's actually gone back to Scientology on a number of cases. Yeah, that's a more modern phone number. But there's no actual date easily seen in this book. Oh yeah. Ooh, this is actually 1993 paperback edition. First printing... Nope, 1994 third printing. So, even in recent times, the same stuff, which is completely out of date, is still being reprinted by the cult today. However, so when it comes to the cult itself, avoid it. If you're interested in this way of going forward, avoid the cult's way, follow the link to the free zone, and get in touch with the organizations below. Be aware that the cult itself operates under a number of different guises, a number of different fronts, and different company names. The minute that you're asked to part with a reasonable amount of cash for testing or auditing, that should send off alarm bells, and you're probably in one of the cult's nom de plumes by business standards, whatever the heck that is. Does the tech itself work? Geir Isene is one of the people who also left the cult and has... I've got a link to his site. This is his modern site, and he has a number of things. He has some specific stuff on Scientology, why he left, and a section on, although I do not consider myself a Scientologist, I believe that the Scientology philosophy is valuable. The church has long since departed from its teachings, and there's a lot of stuff to read there for you. But the ultimate thing is that Geir's thought process is definitely working along the lines that most of the rest of us are working on. The same questions are being asked. like, what is reality? Is Pluto a planet? Not anymore. August the 24th marks the 5th year anniversary where the International Astronomical Union changed the definition of what constitutes a planet, and little Pluto was summarily removed from the prestigious list. Our solar system went from 9 to 8 planets with a show of hands. Reality was changed. Is Facebook really worth gazillions of dollars? Is an ounce of gold really worth what someone says it is? Is Mona Lisa really a beautiful painting? If you think it represents beauty, you will see beauty. If not, you will see old colour on canvas, or even ugliness. You know, the definitions and the questions of what is reality and all the rest of it. And for Geir, he says that the process of the philosophy of what Scientology is based on has helped him. And that is ultimately the kind of thing that you need to be asking yourself. If you are asking questions and you are wanting to find routes forward for your soul, then it is one of the potential ways forward that's out there. But you need to be careful not to get sucked up into the cult. Otherwise, things could end up quite nasty. And there's, from some of the books that I've been reading and from some of the blogs and publications of people who have been in and have left, including Tanya's accounts, they're pretty scary, you know? So, if the philosophy of talking things through in order to work them out of your system appeals, then it's worth looking into. But just be careful of who you're talking to, and especially careful of who you're handing over any money to. I hope that's given you a very broad overview of the kind of thing that's going on here, and why protesters are protesting against the cult, why people have left it, and why there's a lot of accusations going on, and all the rest of it that the cult is facing. So, that is as broad an overview as I can possibly give you. I'm wondering if there's anything else that I've missed out, anything else that I've left out of this. I don't think I have. Catch you on the next video. Take care. Bye.